Welcome to our Piping Engineering YouTube channel. We continue our free piping education videos in this channel. In this video, we will show step-by-step how to calculate the distance between the centers of the elbows and the length of the brown pipe piece between these elbows in the 3D model of a pipeline. Before starting this video, please subscribe to our education YouTube channel to watch more piping engineering videos. Let's starting pipe tutorial video. We will be tried to explain with examples in this video how to calculate the length of the brown color pipe piece and center to end dimensions of the 40 degree cut elbows in this 6-inch pipeline. As you can see, 6-inch pipeline comes first horizontal then vertical up with 40 degree elbow and then continue horizontally with 40 degree elbow again. At the same time, the pipeline has turned 310 mm to the right horizontally, looking from the second elbow to the first elbow. To make it easier to understand the turning of the pipeline from the second elbow, I have shown the turning part of the pipeline inside the parallelogram. As you can see, the first elbow in the pipeline is located in the lower left corner of the parallelogram, and the second elbow is located in the upper right corner of the parallelogram. To find the length of this inclined piece of pipe between the elbows, we must first calculate the distance between the centers of the pipe elbows. Then from this distance we subtract the lengths of the two 40-degree elbows and the spaces for welding. Two right triangles are formed with dashed lines after the pipe line rises vertically obliquely and turns 310 mm to the right from the second elbow. Let's mark the vertical right angle triangle formed by dashed lines with blue color. Let's mark the horizontal right angle triangle formed by the dashed lines with red color. The hypotenuse of the vertically blue right angle triangle is the distance between the elbows in the pipe line. Let's mark the hypotenuse of this vertical blue right-angle triangle with big letter H. Let's mark the hypotenuse of the horizontal red right-angle triangle with small letter H. Now let's begin to find the lowercase letter H, which is the hypotenuse of the horizontal right-angle triangle. Let's remove the extra lines of the parallelogram to see the calculations more clearly. The perpendicular sides of this horizontal right-angle triangle are 770 mm and 310 mm. We will use the Pythagorean theorem formula in such cases to calculating the hypotenuse of this right-angle triangle. According to the Pythagorean theorem, 770 squared plus 310 squared is equals small little h squared. Continued to calculate and found the small h squared is equals 689,000. We continue, small h is equals 689,000 under root. At last we will use scientific calculator and found small h is equals 830 millimeters. Is the hypotenuse of the horizontal red color right angle triangle and is also one of the perpendicular sides of the vertical blue right angle triangle. Now let's find the big letter H, which is the hypotenuse of the vertical blue right angle triangle. We will use the Pythagorean theorem formula again in such cases to calculating the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle. According to the Pythagorean theorem, 830 squared plus 390 squared is equals big little h squared. Continued to calculate and found the big little h squared is equals 841,000. We continue, big H is equals 841,000 under root. At last we will use scientific calculator and found big H is equals 917 millimeters. 917 millimeters is the hypotenuse of the vertically blue right triangle and is also the distance between the centers of the 40 degree but weld elbows. So, the overall length between the centers of the 40-degree but weld-cut elbows is 917 millimeters. If we subtract the lengths of the 40-degree cut elbows and the gaps for welding from this total length, we can find the length of the brown color pipe section. Now let's calculate 40-degree cut elbows lengths. Formula for calculating center to end distance of such cut elbows is as follows. Elbow length is equals tangent, elbow degree divided by 2, multiplying 1.5, multiplying nominal pipe size of elbow NPS, multiplying 25.4. Now we can use scientific calculator and calculate the length of the 6-inch 40-degree elbow with this formula. 6-inch 40-degree but weld elbow center to end dimension is equals tangent 40 divided 2 multiplying 1.5, multiplying 6, multiplying 25.4. We used scientific calculator and found 6-inch 40-degree but weld elbow center to end dimension is equals 83 millimeters. Now, look at the fit-up process pipe fittings each other in this pipe line. During fit-up, such are opened between the pipe fittings to be welded, and a gap of approximately 3 to 4 millimeters. Having this gap is for better root welding. We should take these gaps into account when calculating the length of the brown color pipe section. Let's start to calculate this brown color pipe section length. Pipe length is equal, total length 917 mm, minus 2 times 6-inch 40-degree but weld elbow dimension 83 mm, and minus 2 times gaps for welding 3 mm. At last we calculate and found length of 6-inch brown color pipe section on this pipe line is 745 mm. By using this method, you can easily calculate lengths of pipe pieces in the any pipe lines. This tutorial video is finishing here. If you have any question about video, you can write comments in the comments section. You can watch videos about pipe length calculation, pipe slope calculation, piping isometric drawing, welding symbols, pipe fittings by entering the links in the description below of this video. By watching and liking our videos, you will help the development of education YouTube channels. If you liked our video, please subscribe to our piping engineering channel. Thank you for watching. See you on next video. Take care.